blood of mine king covereth my hands, thus proving mine crime heinous and unruly. Anon yon the deed is done, I have felt much regret. How couldst I kill him? At which hour that gent hadst been so kind to me, and I hadst nay justifiable reason for doing so.
O noble Thane, is thy deed done?
Don't smock me, hag. There is nothing gentle surrounding my horrendous crimes. Tis done in haste and horror, yet...
Yet?
Not one gent shall pay attention to its devilish nature. Does mine deed follow the horrible prediction by thee, hags?
If it be true, thee never commit treason. Thee shall be known as one of the most prominent kings in Scotland yet.
I gauge to be the most gentle and kind to mine own servants and acquaintances. I shall never again kill in mine own life.
Stay careful for what thee commit too suddenly. The future hath many twists and turns, most unexpected.
Doth thee know how mine own reign shall be?
Thy time as king shall be most wondrous, yet not so.
Shall mine own name carry on to future royalty?
Thy son shall be king, yet not thy successor.
These hags know not what they speak of. Mine reign wilt be long and plentiful. O'er the land about, friends of the crown will shout and mine honor. I was provoked to kill the king ere me, and now I sit in his chair most royal. The deed is done and over with. His death requires me to lead on the most honorable reign ever seen. Thee maketh no sense with thy speech. Wherefore wouldn't I pass on the crown to mine own son?
O king, it is the prophecy thee speaks of.
What prophecy?
Your majesty, do not fret. Thy reign's honor is up to thee, yet not thy length up to the promise thy swore upon.
Thy riddles leave no sense to the mind. Thou speak what not thou know. Answer me to what I ask, or I shall be forced to bloody conflict.
O king, while these sayings may not satisfy you at this hour, they shall anon.
Stay careful with the watching eye, or your generous person shall end you.
All hail Duncan, King of Scotland.